Hi everyone, in this video, we're gonna cover some really exciting subjects such as when do you actually short a stock? Look, it's obvious, right? If you know what a bad stock is, you can just short it. But really, are you gonna get the results by simply knowing that the stock's got bad prospects? Well, sometimes it's exactly when you enter the position is gonna determine whether your position is gonna ultimately turn profitable or not. So in this video, I will show you specifically how by utilizing certain charts and chart patterns, you will be able to be more right than wrong in identifying your entry opportunities. So if you're a stock trader or an options trader trying to figure out, well, what is the best time to enter into my short positions? This video is definitely packed with a ton of useful information. And following up on the video I posted yesterday about Tesla predicting a 95% price drop, I think you'll be pleased to know that in this video, I will actually reveal exactly when I will be opening my short position. So if you watched the video yesterday and you were like, okay, well, you know, maybe I should short Tesla, and you're trying to figure out, well, do I do it today? Do I do it tomorrow? Do I wait a couple of months and then do it? This video, at the very end, I will give you specific answers of when and why and how to open your short position. So when is actually the best time to short a stock? Look, and this could be very, very counterintuitive to a lot of you. Typically, you know, if you've been trading stocks or options, the general rule of thumb is you want to buy low and sell high. Well, clearly, when you're playing the long side of the market, buying long is when the stock is trading at its very low level in relation to its historic levels, right? So buying low, sell high is pretty obvious here. Now, what does actually mean buying low and sell high when you play in the opposite side of the market, when you actually shorten the stocks? And by the way, by using the term shorten here in our channel, we typically don't short the stocks themselves, but we short stocks through utilizing the simplest form of put options, that's buying put options. Okay, so what does buy low and sell high mean in the context of shorting the stock? It's actually exactly the opposite, and that is why it's so counterintuitive to many people. You actually want to short the stock when it's going higher, not lower. And there's a number of reasons for that. But the key answer to the question, what is the best time to short a stock? It's shorting it at the top. So if you want to write this down as you're watching this, if you're really trying to master how to short stocks, how to have winning trades to the extent of 400 or 500%, 1,000%, then start with shorting the stocks at the top. So short at the top is the key. Why is it so important? Well, a lot of times people are the creatures of habit, they're emotional creatures, right? So typically people want to short the stock when it's actually going lower. When certain stock traders, they look at the screen and the stock may be dropping for the first day and they're like, ah, I missed it, you know? And then the stock is dropping the second day and they're like, well, no, there's no way I'm getting in now, it's too late. You know, it dropped too much. Guess what happens when the stock drops for the third day? They're like, oh man, I gotta get a piece of this action. I gotta get in. It looks like it's just gonna keep falling and falling. And so what do you think happens exactly when that takes place? Well, the stock reverses and it actually bounces higher. So what happens to that trader? Well, typically the stop loss works and the position is liquidated, right? So the trader at this point is out of the position. So to avoid situations like that, you have to do literally exactly the opposite. And so the main argument against that would be, well, how do I nail the top? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you exactly some of the things that you could observe to increase your probability of identifying the top. Now, shorting at the top, this is what it will do for you. It actually represents the minimum amount of risk, and I'll explain that in detail in just a second. Also, when a stock is going higher and you're buying put options, that is actually representing the lowest cost of entry to you, because apparently when the stock is going higher, what happens to your put options? Well, they go down in value. So when put options go lower in value, that represents typically the lowest point at which you're going to be able to acquire these put options. So which is exactly the definition that we're trying to accomplish, is buying low and sell high. So we buy put options at their lowest level when the stock is actually going higher, not when it is apparent to everybody that the stock is dropping. So if you use this rule of buy low and sell high, and you catch the stocks at the top, then it gives you actually a huge flexibility on exiting your position. Just, I'll use a basic example. If you're buying your put option at the very top for $2, okay, by the time it reverses, it moves lower, well, your options, your put option at this point appreciate very quickly when everyone realizes, oh, the stock is not going higher anymore. Clearly, it's reversing, it's going lower. So you can easily get out of your position at $4, $6. Well, guess what happens to the people that are just realizing, oh, that stock is not going higher anymore? Well, at what level are they buying their put options? Well, they're buying them at 200% higher. They're buying them at $4. They're buying them at $6 while you are buying them at $2. So pretty simple example, pretty simple math, right? So in order for you to realize, you know, a huge gain, you can get in at two, get out at 4-6 with a, you know, 200-300% return while they're just getting in. And for them to be able to realize similar returns, let's say if they're getting in at 6, they'd have to get out at 12 or 18 to realize the same gains that you have. Also, when the stock is moving higher and it's reaching certain levels of resistance, or it's basically trading to closer to its stop range, it really represents low upside situation for the stock and huge downside situation. Because more often than not, the stock is going to stop opposite the resistance level and quickly make another pullback, which in a lot of cases results sometimes in 15 to 20% pullbacks. I'm going to show you 15 examples of those situations in just a second. What is the best time to short Tesla stock? I'll answer that question at the very end of this video. So example number one, what are we talking about here? Double top reversal example. And so we're talking about shorting at the top. Example number one is stock of YY. Now, in addition to clearly observing the top, which is right here, at a range of about $140. Now, the definition of a top is this. They don't have to be identical, right? They could be within a few percent. I'd say within 3 to 5% is what would be considered a double top. You will be able to observe certain bearish signs the second time the stock actually tries to come up higher and break this high level that was set previously. Observe the RSI. This divergence in RSI is clearly gonna give you a sign of what would be a double top formation that could result in a huge pullback in the stock. In this case, you see when the stock was trading right here at the 140 at the first stop, the RSI was in the green area. In other words, it was way above 70, more closer to like 80. The second time the stock tried to run up to this 140 level, look where the RSI was. It was significantly lower. It was about in the 60 range. And then when it started selling off, it hit a low of 55. Before that drop actually materialized on this high, high volume right here, which exceeds all the other volumes on this chart for YY, we already had a bearish MACD cross right here. And the accumulation distribution started falling like a rock right at about the same time. So look, I'll say this. If you're getting puzzled with this or some of this does not make sense to you, this is why here at MarketCrash.money, we're recording a course, a chart course. So if charts are not your best friends or they're not your best friends yet and you're planning on being successful at trading stocks or options, make sure that charts do become your best friends. And you can do that by clicking the link below and taking the chart course so you can understand all these things. And we can break out the most complex charts into simple terms that are going to be able to help you make really good trading decisions. So let's move on and see what actually takes place to YY next. You're going to be able to observe a $50 drop right after the double top was created. From roughly 140, the stock drops into just under $90. So here's that move. And please observe how quickly that move actually materializes. So we're talking about stocks going lower much faster than they go higher. And this is why shorting stocks could be such a profitable opportunity if you know when to get in your entry points, okay? So double top reversal, example number two. In this case, CAC Credit Acceptance Corporation drops from 378 to 351 in 5 days. Now, please keep in mind, some stocks are going to have much larger DTR or daily trading range than some of the others. So for some stocks, you know, a $30 drop is a huge drop. For some stocks, like Google and Amazon, a $30 drop could happen in 1 day. So please, when we're reviewing these drops, always try to put in the context the historic trading ranges for some of these stocks. And so in case of CACC, even though it did drop on occasions as much as $20 a day, this a $7 drop, a matter of 5 days, is actually a huge drop for this particular stock. And what I'd like to point out is, again, you will start seeing the divergences on the RSI line, your relative strength index, right? When the stock was trading right here at 360, please take a look at where the RSI was. It was way above 70. Now, this time, the stock price goes higher to 375. What happens to the RSI? It actually goes lower. Well, in reality, if the stock is going to break out and sustain the all new time high levels, what you should be seeing is the RSI typically moving to the upside as well. But in this case, it's quite significantly lower. So at a lower range, RSI was higher. When the stock price moved higher, the RSI dropped. That is your case of a divergence followed by this consecutive drop. And the reason the consecutive drop is crucial, if you trade in options, then you don't want a situation where once day the stock goes lower, the next day it goes higher, then it goes lower, then it goes higher. And so ultimately it may be a downward trend. But if you're trading options short term, if you're doing weekly, bi-weekly, a few weeks out, okay, and those typically are the type of options that will generate you the highest returns. But then what you need to look at is situations like this when you have consecutive days lower and lower. So this is the type of environment that creates returns for you to the extent of 600, 700, 800, sometimes 2,000%, right? It's the consecutive downward movement in a particular stock. All right, let's take a look at the next example here. Double top reversal example three, ANAB dropped from 135 to 80 right after the double top formation right here. Again, I'd like to point out the divergence in the RSI. So here the stock tried to run up one time to the 135 range. RSI was at 70. The second time tries to run up there, the RSI actually is clearly lower than the previous RSI high set right here. So after that, the stock reverses, hits a low of under 80 bucks, like $78. Let's take a look at the next example. Double top example number four. Arista Networks, ticker ANET. The stock drops from 300 to 240 bucks. And actually, if you observe this, we have multiple situations which you would have been able to profit on the short side in this particular stock. Very highly predictive. So you've got a double top right here. Here's your first top. Here's your second top. Second top doesn't take the 300 level out. Drops all the way to 240. Makes another run. This time it tops out about 275. First top, second top at 275. After that, drops all the way to 235. Makes another run higher. This time it sets a top at around 285. You see a smaller time frame, right? But clearly there's the first top right here at 285, second top right here at 285. After that, falls drastically to 252. So just on this chart alone, you had three huge opportunities to short the stock. And again, your RSI was a giveaway in this particular case as well. So it's not just the double top formation that you'd like to see. You also want to observe the divergences in some other categories. And ideally, you want to have a number of divergences, which is not the case of this video. We go fertilely in with about 100 examples of different divergences that take place to help you really make sense out of these charts in a very simple way. And by giving you a ton of examples, you know, when you're looking at the stocks that are on your watch list that you're looking to trade, you're going to be able to observe that there's similarities in a lot of these graphs. And that's going to help you identify a lot of great trading opportunities with ease. Okay, next example is S&P 500 dropped from 2775 to 2560. Okay, so here's your first top, here's your second top. After that, you have a huge reversal going lower to 2560. Huge drop, again, in a very short amount of time that was highly predictable. Double top example number six, a drop from 240, 290 in shares of 3M. Wow, even good stocks drop too. Imagine this. A lot of times I see traders trying to identify the worst stocks out there so they can short them. Well, sometimes when you try to find the worst stocks, the reason why they're rated the worst stocks is because they have already fallen significantly. And when the stock has dropped 50, 60, 70%, well, yes, there is a chance it will continue falling, but it's not the overall fall that you're looking for, right? It's when is that fall is going to take place. And in a stock that has fallen 50, 60, 70%, well, at that point, there's a good chance that the stock is oversold. So no matter how bad of a company, how bad of the stock it is, the stock could be easily positioned for a bounce. So you don't want to typically short the stocks at their very bottom because you're always faced with a potential run-up or possibly a short squeeze situation or something of that nature. So shorting at the top is a much better strategy. And clearly we see even some of the best companies do qualify for that as well. Double top and 3M, here's your first top, here's your second top. Then a drastic fall from 240 to 190 in just a matter of a few weeks. Okay, next example, double top example number seven. Now, World Acceptance Corporation. Now, this is actually an early stage, right? This is a double top that was just created, so we may see some more room to run. Now, this is not a very high volatility stock, so may not drop as quickly as we'd like it to see, but we're definitely observing some signs that this stock is due for a reversal. So here's your first top, here's your second top, here's the move lower. We're also seeing some other indications with a particular type of a candle. There's just a number of things like a MACD just started pointing lower that tells us that this stock can have a much bigger move than from 125 drop to 113. In other words, that move could be more sustainable over long term. We can possibly see the stock about $96. And it's also confirmed the accumulation distribution as the stock moved higher. Not many people are too excited about it, buying it at this level. They're using this opportunity to actually sell it. Double top example number eight, CMI drops from $170 to $133. Here's a clearly identified double top, top one, top two. After that, stock goes from $170 all the way down to $133. Actually, we're trading as low as about 131, 132 a share. Okay, double top example number nine, MIDD, ticker symbol, dropped from 132.5 to 100. And this is a crazy lightning fast drop, right? So first stop, and which interestingly, this chart actually is a lot more bearish than some of the other ones we've looked at. It is also characterized as what you can see I outline here in these orange gaps. These orange gaps are quite bearish because that means that the day following the previous close, the stock gapped lower, significantly open at a much lower price than it was trading the day before. And we have two cases scenarios. A lot of times I like to catch them when they gap down and then they try to gain some momentum and they go higher. This is typically a good time to short. You could have technically counted this as a double top to this. In this case, I'm using, which followed, by the way, with a drop here, created another top. So technically, we can make a case for a triple top situation here. But for this example purposes, let's consider this the second top. And so at about 132.5, again, this was maybe at 132. This was maybe 132.60 right here. Again, they're not going to be identical down to a penny, but they're going to be pretty close, right? So after that, the stock drops all the way to $100 within what? Within literally a day or 2 days. So very fast move, exceeding 30% drop. That's exactly what you want to see for trading options. Now, coincidentally, I mentioned that this chart is a lot more bearish than some of the other ones. This also is accompanied by this death cross. And if you're not sure what the death cross is, in our chart course, I give close to like 20 examples of death crosses that help you identify some fake death crosses, some real death crosses that could be followed with a much major follow through on the way lower. So if you're curious what they are, how to use them, it's very simple. Just simply click the link below and sign up for the course and take action. Double top example number 10, steady consecutive drop from 100 to 87 bucks, right? Looks kind of boring after some of the other drops we've witnessed so far, but look, none the case, a very clearly identified top. And as I mentioned, some stocks are just not going to be as volatile. So if you're a little bit more of a conservative type investor and you don't like this high volatility stock, look, what you may want to consider is just slow and steady. This stock does not drop, you know, 30 bucks on any given day. But as you can see, when it starts moving lower, it surely keeps that tendency over the course of time, which we can observe, for example, here. 3 days consecutive lower, 4 days consecutive lower, 5 days consecutive lower. Combination pretty mixed with a couple of days up, but overall lower. Same thing here. So this double top, if you were to identify that, this two-week option or a monthly option would have produced some significant traction. And you would be able to lock some really good gains, okay? So again, drop from, what do we have, 100 to 87. In a very short amount of time, nice, slow, steady, consecutive drops. As you can see, some other indications pointing to possibly even a lower drop here, as the MACD indication showing a very bearish reading as well. Double top example number 11, from 211 bucks to 182 and a half on the stock of BABA. And you know, BABA has been on a solid, solid run higher. So how could we have actually identified this double top before it happened? Well, very easily. Okay, you see the first time BABA runs up here, look at the RSI. And then the second time it runs into the same level, look at where the RSI is. It's significantly lower. Okay, so the second time you could have easily opened the position here, short at the top, and you would enjoy these nice profits all the way to 182 and a half, which looks like it could continue. Again, it's just not observing the double top is where you should just automatically jump on and say, hey, I'm going short. But take a look at some other indicators, and if they're confirming that this is a top, if you're seeing some other divergence in RSI and some other indicators, then this is going to be probably as risk free of a trade as you're going to be able to obtain from the standpoint of, you know, short selling. So easy chart right here. Double top. Again, BABA is one of the greatest stocks, right? But of course, with the tariffs lately, you know, a lot of people, we can see a lot of sellers coming in. But before this major move happened, and again, the charts didn't know that this situation with the China tariffs is going to intensify, right? But they were already showing us clear signs of divergence that this move lower was going to take place. The charts did not know why, but they were clearly giving us the sign that that move lower was coming after this double top formation. Next example, double top example number 12, shares of DEC. Dropped from 123 to 112, another one of these boring small moves, but good illustration of a divergence in an RSI, and this move lower, again, could have been easily nailed by observing some of these divergences, increase in the sell volume, MACD, and accumulation distribution. Double top example 13. Now, this gets a little bit more exciting. CHRW. What's exciting is not the drop from 100 to 80, but the speed of the drop, right? That drop happens from 100 bucks to $80. So substantial drop for a stock that's not a very high volatility stock, right? But again, this could have done wonders, unbelievable results for your options positions. Again, this is a good illustration that stocks do come down much faster than they go up. And if you know when to get in your positions, this is how you can run up substantial profits trading options. Next example, double top example number 14, Goldman Sachs. Wow, so much stock for all the financials. Oh, they're the best buys right now. Oh, we're loading up. We're buying financials. They're good deals. Really? Then explain this to me, okay? why this was probably one of the best stocks to short among the financials. Like, he could have literally done it 3 or 4 times in a row. And I'll give you a couple of examples right here. So stock drops from 274 to 244. Okay, so this was 274 right here. The stock drops all the way to 244, highlighted by this big blue dot right here. Okay, this was actually a triple top formation as I typed in here. So top one, top two, top three. And please keep this, take a mental picture of this right here, because when I'm gonna answer the question about Tesla, this is gonna be an important observation. Okay, so after the triple top, stock drops from 274 all the way to 244. Great opportunity, because look again, this fall is consecutive. Maybe interrupted just a little bit by a couple of days higher right here, but other than that, it's a smooth ride lower. Now we got a situation of a double top where the stock basically reaches a top of 263. You see these two red candles right here, 263, 263, after that falls all the way to 223. Not a bad drop, $40 drop, pretty nice. Also, you'll see now it's got a bearish cross right here and it's got some other bearish indicators. So as much for all this stock by the financials, right? They were actually some of the best short opportunities over the course of the last couple of months. Double top example 15. Ooh, this is the kind of trades I get excited about, okay? Dropped from 152 to 87. The stock almost gets slashed in half, okay? So again, we're clearly seeing the divergence in the RSI. Here's your top one, here's your top two. After that, the stock tanks from 152 all the way to 87 bucks. But also, we could have identified this upcoming drop by observing this bearish crossover in the MACD and some of the other things. So if you're curious to learn, just click the link below. So when is the best time to short Tesla? This is the question of the day. So before we answer that, let's take a look at the daily chart. What do we see on the daily chart? The stock was just visiting the level of 370. Is that good or bad? Well, it looks like it was visiting closer to that range right here as well. Now, what do we see on the daily chart as far as the divergence on the RSI? So clearly when the stock was here, it was trading at a much higher RSI. Now the stock trades quite a bit lower and at much lower RSI. So what I'd like to do is observe what the stock is going to do this week, because apparently the crowd is cheering. There is a great announcement over the weekend. Actually, the announcement came in before I posted this bearish video yesterday. And I wanted to make this one so it would be clear, even though I'm bearish on Tesla over the next 24 months, the point at which you enter into your bearish position is really crucial. Let's take a look now at another chart. If you've been following some of my videos, I am very adamant about analyzing different time frames on the chart, because a lot of times they're going to give you mixed signals. And what you really want to go with is when those signals are aligning in more ways rather than giving you the mixed signal. So in this case, let's see what is the weekly chart tells us. Keep this image in mind as we're moving on to the weekly chart, right? Before we do, right? So here's some of the divergences already that we're seeing, right? So this is not gonna get any better. Let's say this week the stock moves higher. Well, we're already entering this week, even if the stock does move higher, with a bearish crossover in the MACD and beginning of the distribution when we look at the accumulation distribution index. Okay, so what does that tell us? Overall, I'm a bear on Tesla stock over the next 24 months. So at this point, all I want to do is identify a good entry point for myself to profit from Tesla stock dropping. Now, with the recent short squeeze, right? Because this is exactly what we had here, the short squeeze from 250 to 300, and this is where they really got excited from 300 to 370, this short squeeze right here. Now the situation has come down a little bit, but we may see another move higher, and that's exactly what's most likely going to take place this week. The question to answer is whether that move is going to be sustainable. So again, let's revisit a different time frame right here. On a weekly time frame, we're going to see that Tesla all-time high was reached right here at a level of about 388. It was revisited again to the same level of 388. So we already had a double top formation, after which the stock has fallen all the way to 240. Now, this is going to be a triple top formation at this point. This was taken as of June 29th. So today is July the 2nd. We're going to see the stock move higher after the announcement over the weekend that Tesla reached its targets for production of 5,000 Model 3s. And so, of course, that's great news. That is also, however, something that everybody has been expecting to take place for a number of months. And if you study the behavior of Tesla, every time it's got some kind of exciting announcement coming up, the stock has a tendency to rally, but after the announcement is made, it drops like a rock. So what I'm hoping for here, and when I analyze this type of situations, right, there's going to be a number of scenarios. So let's just walk through each one specifically. So at this announcement, the stock could run up higher, it could pause, and it could go higher. At that point, what am I going to be observing? I'm going to be observing the level of RSI. If the stock keeps moving higher, but the RSI is falling, or it is not going higher, in other words, it's not falling the price action, this is actually going to be sending me a signal of a divergence. And so if it gets to this 370, 380 would not be a bad level to enter. Now, if it gets to all the way here, 388, this is going to be the ultimate perfect level to enter this short position, given the fact that your divergences are also lining up. In other words, the RSI is slowing down. It's not going higher. The RSI is going lower. You got the MACD crossover lower. You've got maybe other signs like volume diminishing on the way higher, but picking up its pace on the way lower. And also pay attention to this accumulation distribution. It looks like with the recent run-up, because of the short squeeze, accumulation is at its all-time high, which is not a bad thing, right? A lot of people are going to say, well, everybody's buying the stock. Exactly, which means to me that a lot of people has been wanting to buy the stock, has already bought the stock. So if it moves higher, some of them are going to start taking profits. And where are they going to be taking profits? They're going to be taking profits right around here at the 380, 390 level if the stock gets there. So that's sort of your variation number one. So the question of the day in this particular case would be, I'm going to open the short position when Tesla stock gets to a range of 380, 390. Now, the second variation could be, as I mentioned, in many instances, when a positive announcement in Tesla comes out, the stock may open what will appear to you as a definite bullish situation where if you look on your screen, everything is going to be green, but it's going to reverse almost immediately. So let's say the stock goes to 360, 365, and then you're seeing some volume coming in and the stock starts selling off. Well, this may be an indication that the stock may not even reach a level of 380, 390. So what I may do is I may start opening the position if it gets to about 360, 365. If you've been following some of my videos, I'm also an advocate for not jumping in and opening a huge position at all at once, right? So sometimes if you're seeing some things are starting lining up for your type of trade, you want to start coming in and maybe start taking some smaller bites. In other words, open a smaller type of position and just see how that position is working for you. And if it starts making you a little bit of money, that probably is a good time to start adding a little bit more to the position. So there's no perfect rocket science, right, to say, oh, for sure, it's going to move to 380 or 388.20, and that's where I'm going to open my entire position. I'm going to wait for 24 months. So I may start building my position at 360, 365 today or tomorrow or Thursday or Friday if I see the stock showing signs of exhaustion. I see some buyers coming in. And the way I'm going to see that is by observing the volume. Not on this chart, not of course on the weekly chart, but I'm going to be observing the volume coming in on 1 day, 1 minute chart, 1 day, 5 minute chart, and so on.
If you're not sure how to read the volume, if you're not sure what the difference between all these charts, again, if you're looking to have results with trading options, or specifically what's going to be more relevant than ever, and that is shorting stocks at their tops as the market environment is changing. Buying the dips is no longer going to be the trend over the next 5 years. It's going to be shorting the top. So if you can master this skill, you will have much better probability of nailing some of the most profitable trades that the market might have presented us with in the entire history of the stock market. So this is why I'm so excited about this. And certainly I'm sharing some good information here that I hope you will be able to capitalize on and capture some great trades for yourself. Okay, so the second answer is I may start buying and opening some Tesla puts as it's reaching this level of 360, 365. If I'm noticing a reversal here, that could indicate the stock may not actually get to this 380, 390 range where I would like to see it ideally for a perfect short. Now, the third variant is this, that the short squeeze are going to continue, and if the RSI is going to set a new high, if the volume on the way higher is going to continue increasing, and if there's bearish indicators on the MACD that we observed on the daily chart are going to flip over and show us some bullish signals, that could actually mean that the stock could take these previous highs established at about 388. And in that case, what you do is you definitely want to close out your position. In other words, if the stock is at 388, you see no divergences, you see no bearish signs, then there is a chance that the stock could move above its previous high of 388. Now, you will be able to observe that actually before it takes place. So don't just look at the double top formation, don't just look at the triple top formation, calculate all the different possibilities of what a stock can do and observe multiple indicators pointing to either divergences of the fact that the stock is going to be a reversion or divergences pointing that the stock could actually be taking that all-time high level and moving above that. To avoid and make this almost a risk-free trade, if you're getting in your position in here at 380, 390 range, right, and if the stock actually moves higher above the 388 range on high volume, you can easily just set a stop loss on your options to where they would be closed out. Let's say if the stock moves above 392 or 395, and that way you can lock in a tiny, small loss and maybe wait for some other signals to come in and short the stock at a better level. Now, if you haven't watched my previous video, my main argument for Tesla going lower is going to be, I made the argument that it's going to be on the demand side. So far, the story on Tesla has been the fact that the demand is so great and the company cannot keep up with the production. Well, now that the production issue has actually been solved, I am indicating that the demand in relation to production is not going to indicate scarcity anymore. It's actually going to show that with more supply, the demand could actually drop. I know it seems like a contradictory statement, but it is based on the fact of deteriorating. If you'd like to learn more about how you can identify more profitable short opportunities, if you'd like to learn more about how to short stocks, I have a unique offer this week where I invite you to join and schedule a 20-minute free coaching session on how to trade stocks and options, or more specifically, how to profit from stocks falling, how to profit from markets falling. If you don't have a strategy, but you've been thinking in the back of your mind, hey, it's a good idea, I could see how the market could definitely fall in the next couple of years, I'd like to know how to profit from that, but you're not sure where to start, you're not sure where to look, definitely schedule this 20-minute coaching session. I'd be happy to answer some of your questions and show you specifically on using my examples of how I turned 12K into 466K in less than 7 hours trading options. Now, keep in mind, that was even without any particular market crash. So if you master these core foundational principles that helped me set my personal records like that, you will definitely be well positioned to take on the what could be one of the biggest crashes in the entire United States history over the course of the next couple of years. So when is the time to take action? The time to take action is now, because when the market is going to fall, and it will, and it's going to be apparent to everyone that it's going to continue falling, it's going to be too late to get into some of these trades. So you want to master the concept, you want to master the principles, you want to learn how to read these charts. Take action now, click the link below, and get the answers that you've been looking for.